Good evening. Hi, my name is Jay Kovacs. I'm the president of the Graduate School Alumni Society. On behalf of the Alumni Society Board of Directors, I'm pleased to welcome you to our annual recognition dinner. On a night when we recognize academic excellence and alumni achievement, I would like to take a minute to pay tribute to the very special group of alumni in attendance. Our Penn State doctoral alumni who've traveled to the campus this weekend to celebrate their 10th, 25th, and 50th anniversary of receiving their doctorate degrees from Penn State. 39 alumni were honored today at a special luncheon with the dean, and we're delighted to have some of them here with us this evening. I'd like to ask those alumni to please stand and be recognized. Thank you. I now have the privilege of introducing Paul Clifford, the CEO of the Penn State Alumni Association. Paul, we're honored that you're representing the Alumni Association this evening. And I don't think I'm supposed to say Paul to the podium.
Thanks, Jay. Where else would you rather be than a room full of Penn Staters? On behalf of our more than 742,000 alumni and our 172,000 Alumni Association members, I want to say thank you and welcome to Penn State. The Penn State Alumni Association is truly honored to partner with the Graduate School and our constituent group, the Graduate School Alumni Society, on this special evening, especially as the Graduate School celebrates its centennial anniversary. Earlier today, as Jay just mentioned, alumni received their doctorates 10, 25, and 50 years ago were recognized. Congratulations to all who have reached milestones of these amazing accomplishments. This evening, we're equally excited to see the fruits of the gift the Alumni Association made to the Graduate School. In 1998, we contributed $1 million to endow the Penn State Alumni Association Dissertation Awards, which recognize and reward outstanding doctoral candidates for their dissertation research. An integral part of the Alumni Association's mission is to support the university's mission of teaching, research, and service. Tonight, we will see that mission come alive as these extraordinary, talented graduate students take the stage. We have every confidence that each of them will go on to lead lives of exceptional leadership and service in their respective professions and bring honor and glory back to their alma mater. Tonight, we'll also announce the Alumni Society Award recipients. The Alumni Association is proud of your professional achievements, and I offer my heartfelt congratulations on your selection for these prestigious honors. I also want to say a sincere thank you to the Graduate School Alumni Society, its board, leadership, and volunteers for everything they do for our students, for the Alumni Association, and for Penn State. Again, it's a privilege and a pleasure to share this special evening with you, our alumni and friends, and our distinguished guests, and our accomplished students. It is also a special honor to learn more about what our future graduate alumni will be researching in the year ahead. Once again, thank you for all you do for the university, for the glory, and for the future. We are
Penn State.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. It is now my honor to introduce Dr. Kathy Drager, Interim Vice Provost for Graduate Education and Dean of the Graduate School, who will preside over this evening's awards presentations.
Thank you, Jay. Good evening. Before we get started, I'd like to make a few announcements. First, And importantly, to keep our program flowing, our meal will be served throughout the presentation of awards. So as I offer my opening remarks, please enjoy your salads and continue to enjoy your meal as it is served. Second, It's really wonderful to be with you all in person tonight. After 2 years of Zoom meetings and attending virtual events, this weekend represents a particularly poignant and meaningful reunion and homecoming for Penn State alumni and friends. Welcome back. I'd like to offer a very special welcome to Executive Vice President and Provost of Penn State, Dr. Nick Jones, and his wife, Judy, and to all members of the university senior leadership team with us this evening. In addition to three alumni that are being recognized, you'll have the pleasure of hearing from 12 outstanding research doctorate students who will share the importance of their research and its real-world impact. I'd like to express my appreciation to the members of the Graduate School Alumni Society Awards Committee for their commitment to the alumni awards process. This year's nominations were extremely competitive, and we appreciate your thoughtfulness in selecting this year's honorees. Would the members of the awards committee please stand so that we can thank you? You did a singular job. And now, to begin the presentation of the Alumni Awards, I invite Provost Jones to join me on the stage. Dr. Jones will be presenting the awards as I introduce each award recipient, and each honoree will then make brief remarks. It is my pleasure to introduce the recipient of the Graduate School Alumni Society Early Career Award. This award recognizes alumni who have demonstrated exceptional success in their chosen field within the first 10 years after earning their graduate degree from Penn State. This year's recipient is Xiaoyun Ding. Dr. Ding, would you please join me at the podium for the presentation of your award? Xiaoyun earned a PhD in Engineering Science and Mechanics from Penn State in 2013. He is currently the Bruce S. Anderson Assistant Professor at the University of Colorado Boulder, where he conducts interdisciplinary research at the frontiers of biomedicine, microfluidics, acoustics, drug delivery, electronics, and micro and nano engineering. His innovative work on biomedical technology has already been published in more than 30 top-ranked journals. In 2021, he earned a $1.8 million grant from the National Institutes of Health to help improve cancer-fighting tools and cut patient costs, exploring ways to streamline delivery of life-saving treatments into immune cells. Dr. Ding is a recipient of numerous prestigious awards, including the 2021 NIH MIRA Early Stage Investigator Award and the 2020 Lab Venture Challenge Award from the University of Colorado. Dr. Ding, I am delighted to present you with the Graduate School Alumni Society Early Career Award in recognition of your outstanding professional achievements. Congratulations. And we now invite you to say a few words.
Well, thank you, Dean Drager, for your introduction. I didn't know I'm so good until I hear Dr. Drager's words. I'm so grateful and humbled to receive this prestigious award. And it's really such an honor to stand around so amazing group of alumni together. I want to start by thanking the Penn State Graduate School and in general Penn State for sponsoring this award and event. It's so great to be back to Happy Valley and look around the school that I spent four of the most memorable years of my life. Penn State is the first stop I came to this country to chase my American dream to be a professor. And Penn State is also one of the most important parts of my academic career life. I really thrived as a PhD student under pressure and the challenge at Penn State in the College of Engineering, Department of Engineering Science and Mechanics. So many of the opportunities I have received are the results of others who trusted me. I'm so fortunate and blessed to have so many supporters who always mentored me, encouraged me, and helped me along the way. It is the least that I can do to continue the spirit to encourage and educate the next generation. Lastly, I would like to appreciate my family, especially my incredible wife, who is a great supporter behind me. Although she cannot be here today, she wished to because she needs to take care of our newborn baby who is too young to fly. And also I want to thank my spiritual parents, Don and Myrna Hines, who are here. And they are always with me spiritually and physically. Again, I truly appreciate this honor and thank you very much. We are.
Thank you, and once again, congratulations. I'm now delighted to introduce the recipient of the Graduate School Alumni Society Humanitarian Award. This award recognizes alumni who have made a positive societal impact on the welfare of humankind beyond the responsibilities of one's profession. This includes contributions benefiting one's community, state, nation, or people of other nations. This year's recipient is Dr. Judy Wakungu. Dr. Wakungu, would you please join us at the podium for the presentation of your award. Thank you. And I screwed up before, so we're going to wait for the picture. Since earning a PhD in energy resources management from Penn State in 1993, Judy Wakungu has directed the skills and knowledge gleaned during her doctoral education to improving the lives of others. After graduation, she spent several years at Penn State as Associate Professor, Science, Technology, and Society, and Founding Director of the Women in Science and Engineering, or WISE Institute. It is fitting she led an institute focused on trailblazing women, as she is truly a woman of firsts. She was the first woman geologist in the Ministry of Energy and Regional Development in Kenya, the first female petroleum geologist to serve in the National Oil Corporation of Kenya, and the first woman faculty member in the Department of Geology at the University of Nairobi. After leaving Penn State, she returned to Kenya and served as the Cabinet Secretary for Environment and Natural Resources. She was responsible for ensuring good governance in the protection, restoration, conservation, and management of the environment and natural resources. She made evidence-based science policy the cornerstone of her agenda. Her many accomplishments include implementing the Climate Change Act, the Water Act, and facilitating the country's first nationwide ban on single-use plastic polythene bags. Since 2018, Dr. Wakungu has served as ambassador of Kenya to the French Republic, Portugal, Serbia, and the Holy See. In this diplomatic capacity, she's Kenya's highest ranking representative with responsibility for stewarding negotiations and delivering bilateral messages on behalf of Kenya. Her work centers on broad issues of trade, peace and security, and environmental issues. An advocate for the protection of elephants, she made global headlines in 2016 as she championed the burning of Kenya's entire stockpile of ivory and rhino horns. She's a member of the Giants Club, which brings visionary leaders together to support the protection of elephants. Dr. Wakungu, we are honored to present you with the 2022 Graduate School Alumni Society Humanitarian Award. And we now invite you to speak a few words.
Distinguished guests, it's a great honor for me to be back home at Penn State. Everything I have accomplished was imbued and inculcated in me here. During my tenure at Penn State, I had so many role models that my greatest fear was that I would let them down. I have done much, yes, I have, but it has been with the help of all of my friends, my brothers, and my sisters here at Penn State. I will continue to make you proud, just as you make me proud on every single day. Thank you very much, and we are Penn
I am now delighted to introduce the recipient of the Graduate School Alumni Society Lifetime Achievement Award. This award is presented to alumni who have achieved exceptional success throughout this course of their career and have demonstrated loyalty to the university and to the Penn State Alumni Association. This year's recipient is Dr. Gregory Miller. Dr. Miller, would you please join us on the podium for the presentation of your award by Provost Jones. Greg Miller earned a Master of Science in Nutrition from the College of Health and Human Development in 1982 and a Doctorate in Nutrition and Toxicology from the College of Health and Human Development in 1986. A world-renowned expert on nutrition and food systems, Dr. Miller is Chief Science Officer at the National Dairy Council, Executive Vice President of Research, Regulatory, and Scientific Affairs for Dairy Management Incorporated, and Global Dairy Sector Lead for National Security for Global Dairy Platform. In his leadership roles, he works with industry, academic, governments, NGOs, and other professionals to build the technical research needed to understand sustainable food systems to deliver good nutrition. He's currently leading an effort to enhance science that contributes toward a more sustainable global food system by promoting activities at the intersection of nutrition, health, food insecurity, and environmental impact. He advises health professional organizations, industry, and governments around the globe. As spokesperson for national and global dairy sectors and nutrition organizations, Dr. Miller has appeared on the Today Show, CNBC, CNN, and has been quoted in the New York Times, Chicago Tribune, Financial Times of London, and many other publications. An engaged member of the scientific community, Dr. Miller has presented more than 110 invited lectures at national and international meetings and published more than 135 research papers, reviews, articles, and abstracts. He is co-author of the Handbook of Dairy Foods and Nutrition. He's a past member of the board of directors for the American Society of Nutrition and American College of Nutrition, and president of the American College of Nutrition. Since earning his graduate degrees, he's maintained very strong ties to Penn State. He shares his research and industry expertise with faculty and graduate students. He was a founding member and president of the Penn State Nutrition and Dietetics Alumni Society in the College of Health and Human Development. A life member of the Penn State Alumni Association, he has established a doctoral award fund in the College of Health and Human Development in honor of Evan Pugh University Professor of Nutritional Sciences, Dr. Penny Chris Etherton. We're delighted that Dr. Chris Etherton and her husband Terry are with us tonight as well. Dr. Miller has received numerous awards during his career, including the Penn State Alumni Fellow Award in 2003. In June of this year, he will return to campus to receive the Distinguished Alumni Award, the highest honor Penn State bestows upon its graduates. Dr. Miller, congratulations on your distinguished career and outstanding professional success. We are absolutely delighted and proud to present you with the Lifetime Achievement Award. And we invite you to say a few words.
Thank you. Wow, what a great honor to be here with you tonight. And I am humbled and really grateful for this award. And while I get this recognition, like the speakers before me, I haven't gotten here by myself. It's been with the people who've supported me and mentored me and taught me along the way that brought me here. I don't think, you know, you get this kind of success on your own. It's with the people that you work so closely with. I want to thank Penny Chris Etherton and Bob Roberts for nominating me for this award. It's great when you can come back to the university and the professors who are on campus here are not only people who help mentor you, but they're also your friends. That's what's so great about Penn State is the closeness that you build with the people that are here. And of course, I wouldn't be here without my wife, Annette Miller. She is the rock of our family. She has put up with my long hours, my travel schedule, and been there to support me all along the way. So thank you, honey. There have been many others along the way who have mentored me, who have trained me, who have worked side by side with me, and I thank all of them as well, too. So thank you very much, and we are.
Congratulations again, Dr. Miller. Third time's the charm. I think I did it right that time. So at this time, we will take a break. I think they're allowing us to eat. So, and I will invite you to enjoy your meal. And after that, we will present the Alumni Association Dissertation Awards. Hello again, everybody. We will now recognize this year's recipients of the Alumni Association Dissertation Awards, but please continue enjoying your meal. I promise dessert is on the way soon. And we did pretty good at a table of nutrition experts over here, but dessert is on the way. The Alumni Association Dissertation Award recognizes outstanding achievement in PhD research, scholarship, and professional accomplishment. The awards provide support for students who have passed their comprehensive exams and have received approval of their dissertation topics. Nominations are solicited from the 93 research doctorate programs at Penn State. A minimum of two awards of $5,000 each are made in each of the following disciplinary categories: arts and humanities, social and behavioral sciences, physical and computational sciences, life and health sciences, and engineering. Funds for these awards were made possible by a generous gift from the Penn State Alumni Association. This year, 13 awards are presented, but one recipient, Jillian Strayhorn from the College of Health and Human Development, is not able to join us. Dr. Provost Jones will again join me here and present the awards as I announce each recipient. And the scholars have agreed to briefly tell us about their research in their own words. So as I call your name, please join Provost Jones on stage. After you receive your awards, we'll get a photo, you'll share brief remarks about your research, and then you may return to your seat. So our first award is for Mahabubul Alam, Electrical Engineering. Please come forward.
At first, I would like to thank, express my gratitude to the Penn State Alumni Association for their generous support. I'm grateful to the jury who deemed me worthy of this prestigious award. I want to thank my advisor, Dr. Shaurubh Ghosh, for his continuous guidance and support. I work in quantum computing. Quantum computers are not yet suitable to solve practical problems due to their limited capabilities. Quantum classical hybrid algorithms are being investigated to gain quantum advantage with noisy and small quantum computers in the near term. My research focuses on identifying the sources of inefficiencies in these hybrid algorithms and devising techniques to improve their performances. My work will improve the noise resilience of quantum approximate optimization algorithm, a potential hybrid algorithm to solve combinatorial optimization problems. My work will make it useful to solve a variety of optimization problems in the field of electronic design automation, finance, healthcare, cybersecurity, and many other fields. My research also demonstrates a method for constructing large-scale quantum machine learning models using a collection of small quantum neural networks and thus achieve robustness against noise. I have also demonstrated applications of different quantum machine learning models in image classification, protein classification, and drug-like molecule generation. These works could stimulate future advancements in these fields by other researchers. Thank you again.
Congratulations. Jiayin Dong, Astronomy and Astrophysics, please come forward.
So it's great pleasure to be here tonight, and I also heard astronomy could be an after-dinner chatter topic, so hope you enjoy this part of research I'm going to talk about. Exoplanetary science is a field full of surprises, especially the discovery of giant planets with orbits much closer to Mercury's orbits of the Sun. That's totally inspires my dissertation work, which is to build new planet formation models to explain this new type of discovered exoplanets. And I use numerical simulations to model planet formation and make predictions. And then I use state-of-art observing facilities to discover and characterize exoplanets and test my proposed theories. I led the discovery of 50 such close-in giant planets, including one with one of the most elliptical orbits we observed, and one with one of the recognized as one of the youngest known close-in giant planets. So these discoveries help us to better understand how close-in giant planets formed and make promising prediction or evidence that these close-in giant planets have multiple origins. And my research on those close-in giant planets beyond our solar system help us to better think of our place in the universe. And the study of this formation processes of the giant planet that might affect the habitability of the system help us to rethink what habitable worlds means in presence of giant planets. So but at the end, I want to thank the Alumni Association for recognizing the importance of my work. And starting this summer, I will be a postdoc fellow at the Flatiron Institute. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Suzanne Fleischman, Ecology, please come forward.
Hi, everyone. First, I would like to thank my advisors who are both here tonight, Michaela Centenari and Dave Eisenstadt. I'm also lucky that one of my committee members has another student who had an award, so thanks, Terry, for being here and our program chair, Jason. And also to the Alumni Association, thank you so much for this award. It's a great honor to receive it, and I'm very excited to hear about all the other research from the different students tonight. So my PhD is in ecology, but I work in wine grapevine systems and vineyards. And a standard practice in vineyards is to keep part of the vineyard floor weed-free by spraying herbicide. But an alternative practice, instead of spraying herbicide, is to plant grass or other plants underneath the vines. When you plant a grass underneath the vines instead of spraying herbicide, there's a whole host of environmental benefits. You eliminate herbicide, you decrease erosion, you sequester carbon, and I could go on and on and on. But the practice isn't very widely implemented at this point in time because there's a lot of uncertainty in how planting these other plants can impact grapevine growth due to competition for soil resources. So my research is kind of looking at all the mechanisms or different ways that planting a grass ground cover underneath the vines can impact the grapevine growth and environmental aspects in the system. So the hope with this research is by understanding the system better, we can encourage more growers to plant the ground covers and have environmental benefits and also improve production as well. Also because the system involves competition, my work is able to ask a lot of really exciting questions in ecology about competition and how different plants get to coexist in these systems. So thank you.
Congratulations. Jason Griffin, Psychology, please come forward.
Thank you for the introduction. To start, I would like to thank the Penn State Alumni Association for their generosity in honoring me with this prestigious award, an award that supported me not only as the first person in my family to go to college, but also as an early career researcher in the completion of my doctoral degree. My research investigates how individuals on the autism spectrum process information about other people, which makes daily social interactions particularly challenging at times. Using state-of-the-art technology to track eye movements, I have found that individuals on the autism spectrum have difficulty understanding that we use our eyes to communicate nonverbal information. With my advisor, Dr. Susie Scherf, we have developed a computer-based intervention that has we've shown can help individuals on the spectrum better understand these nonverbal social cues. The success of this intervention comes in really exciting times, as the FDA has recently approved the first computer-based intervention for neuropsychiatric disorders. This has far-reaching implications for all kinds of special populations, because these types of digital-based interventions can be deployed easily to a large number of individuals all around the world, and that includes individuals on the autism spectrum. Thanks to the support I have received here at Penn State and the work I've done over the last 4 to 5 years, I have recently accepted a postdoctoral fellowship at the Yale Child Study Center in the Yale School of Medicine, where I will explore how we can use this eye-tracking technology to better develop tools for evaluating the effectiveness of digital-based interventions and other types of interventions more broadly. I am grateful for the amazing training opportunities that I have received here at Penn State with my advisor, Dr. Susie Scherf, and I will carry forward the Penn State name with integrity, responsibility, and exemplary scholarship. Thank you.
Congratulations. Morgan Hasson, French, please come forward.
Thank you for the introduction, and thank you to the Penn State Alumni Association for this award. It's an honor to receive this recognition and to be among brilliant colleagues, scholars, and alumni. My research, located at the intersection of French historical, borderland, and life writing studies, explores how a select group of individuals understood, navigated, and represented intense cultural and political upheaval. Specifically, my dissertation looks at unpublished diaries located in French and German archives and written in the Franco-German borderland of Alsace-Lorraine, a region which experienced two wars and two subsequent sovereignty shifts between 1870 and 1918. These sources reveal how the authors of my corpus experienced traumatic events while living in a world less connected and globalized than ours, when transcultural exposure was less frequent. These unique documents reveal the hardships of war and of the obligation of assimilation almost overnight to a new country, language, and culture. The material documents themselves illustrate how the practice of writing served their authors, often as a creative outlet, a distraction from difficulties, or a means to make sense of the changing world around them. In a time of social upheaval brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic and a war in Ukraine, my research contributes to the growing scholarship valorizing personal writings as historical sources revelatory of how individuals cope with unprecedented times. Thank you to my advisor, who is here with us tonight, Dr. Willa Silverman, for her support. Thank you to my husband for his support. And thank you to the Alumni Association for this honor.
Congratulations. Samantha Hartman, biochemistry, microbiology, and molecular biology, please come forward.
I want to start off by saying thank you to the Alumni Association, and thank you to everyone who's here tonight. It's really exciting to hear about previous alumni's research and all the current students that I'll be graduating with. Also, thank you to my advisor, Susan Hoffenstein. She's been a key part of me getting this far and getting this award. And thank you to the support of my fiance, Luke, who's here tonight as well. So my dissertation research focuses on the structure of viruses. So I'm sure everybody's sick of hearing about viruses at this point. But I specifically have studied papillomaviruses and canine parvoviruses in my dissertation. So the first half of my dissertation focused on papillomaviruses. A lot of us know HPV. And basically, we compared flexibility of these viruses and overcame the flexibility of these viruses to achieve the first atomic resolution structure of a papillomavirus. And in this work, we were able to quantify the flexibility of the virus and then compare the flexibility of a lab-made virus to a native virus. So then the second half of my PhD work focused on virus and antibody interactions, and specifically with canine parvovirus, which is important because it's a virus that has species jumped before. So similarly to COVID, it jumped from one host to another. In this case, it jumped from cats to dogs, creating a pandemic in dogs in the late 70s. If anyone has a dog, your dog is likely vaccinated against it now. But it makes it a really nice tool for us to study vaccine response. So the last part of my dissertation focused on vaccine response and the antibodies that these dogs are creating to vaccination and how that differs between dog to dog and then also with age. So once again, I'd like to thank everyone that's here tonight and thank you to the Alumni Association for this award.
Congratulations. Yu-Chen Hao, Materials Science and Engineering, please come forward.
Hello everyone, I'm Yu-Chen Ho, a PhD student from the Department of Material Science and Engineering. I'm really honored and grateful to be the recipient of the dissertation award this year. I want to express my sincere thanks to the Penn State Alumni Association for this honor. I also want to take this opportunity to thank my parents, my assistant advisor, my lab mates, and also the staffs in the research group. Without their strong support and guidance, this wouldn't be possible. So about my research, in the simple terms, I'm working on exploring the biological materials and principles to design the solar cells. So traditionally, when we think about the solar cells, like the one we saw in the rooftop, we wouldn't think that the biology could be part of that design. But in my research, I have found that there are certain types of biological molecules that can help to improve the stability and also the performance of the solar cell. I also found that these specific biomolecules, they can help to interact with the artificial materials in a very controlled manner, governed by the ionic transport under the light stimulation. So there could be many implications of these findings, and one of the findings could be that we can use this principle to design the artificial coin cells and rod cells that are found in our eye. I'm really excited to pursue these research directions so that on the one hand, we can impact on the renewable energy generation, and on the other hand, we can really make devices that can help to address the vision issues in human body. Thank you so much.
Congratulations. Laura Kaminsky, Plant Pathology, please come forward.
Thank you very much to the Penn State Alumni Association for this award, and I'd also like to thank my advisor, Terry Bell, for his support throughout my work on this degree. So I work with several species of beneficial microorganisms in agricultural systems. So these are microbes that may make nutrients more available to crop plants or suppress plant disease, or in some other way provide a benefit to crop plants in place of conventional fertilizers or pesticides, which have detrimental environmental impacts. And these microbes are increasingly being sold as commercial products to farmers, but they have unreliable results in the field, partially because you're applying a live organism to a whole soil ecosystem of microbes that already exist, and they often get outcompeted. So my PhD research has looked at the interactions between the applied microbes and the microbes that live in the soil already, and also abiotic properties of the soil, such as pH or texture or moisture, that might affect their survival success. So I've developed a PCR system, everyone's familiar with PCRs now, I think, to track their survival success over time and implement interventions to try to improve that establishment success, that these are more useful tools in agriculture going forward. So thank you once again, and have a nice rest of your evening.
Congratulations. Claire Kelling, statistics with a dual title in social data analytics.
Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for this honor. To help describe my research, I'd like you to consider two questions. First, how do elevation and the time of year impact the severity and location of forest fires? Second, in what ways are officer, citizen, and neighborhood characteristics related to police use of force? These two important questions from completely different scientific areas have one thing in common. There are exciting and rich new data sets, commonly called marked point process data, that allow us to answer these questions rigorously. However, existing statistical methods are inadequate for analyzing these data. In my dissertation, I'm developing novel statistical methods for analyzing such data. The models address the challenges of describing marked point process data in terms of both community level and event level characteristics, while preserving the granularity and the utility of the original data sets. Through simulated and real data examples, I find that the models I develop in my dissertation are flexible and easy to interpret. These methods could be applied to a large variety of data sets that are becoming increasingly available, so there's exciting potential for the future impact of this work. Thank you so much to the Penn State Alumni Association for this recognition. I'm also extremely grateful for the support of my advisor, my family, and my father, who's here tonight. And I'm excited to soon join the Penn State Alumni Association, and I'm very, very proud to be a Penn State alumni. We are.
Meredith Laferte Kutu, philosophy.
Hello, everyone. My dissertation in philosophy investigates what makes ethics possible. Even when people do not believe that the world is good, and even when they have no hope that it could ever change. Specifically, I ask, do we keep trying to be good people because we've committed to certain social and personal values? Or is there a more fundamental relationship with goodness that informs the human disposition to be ethical? And to answer this question, I turn to two major figures of 20th century philosophy, Edmund Husserl and Emmanuel Levinas. And I develop an account of responsibility that bears no relationship to power or to freedom. Instead, I argue that we are responsible for much more than what the world has made it possible for us to do. Powerlessness, or the inability to do something, does not liberate us from responsibility. My position presents major advantages over the still widely accepted legalistic account of responsibility, which maintains that a person cannot, in fact, be held responsible for what's beyond her control. First, my view shows that the reason we try to be good, even in a hopeless world, is not that we feel any given way about others, say that we care about them, but that more fundamentally, part of what it means to be a person is already to be bound by responsibility for other people. Second, my view also accounts for why even when people do not try to lead ethical lives, or if they deny their responsibility for the suffering of others, for example, they are still, in fact, just as responsible as everyone else. In short, responsibility is not primarily something that we feel or even that we can take. It's something that we are bound to despite ourselves. My research thereby intervenes in ethical and philosophical debates on the nature and scope of responsibility, on the very meaning of goodness, and on the normative grounds of anything we might call ethical practice. Thank you to my advisor who's here tonight, Nicholas DeWarren, and thank you to the Penn State Alumni Association for this great honor.
Allison Ray, Molecular, Cellular, and Integrative Biosciences.
Hello. As was said, my name is Allison Ray, and I'm a graduate student in the Molecular, Cellular, and Integrative Biosciences program. I'm co-advised by Dr. Christina Grosinger, who is here tonight, as well as Jason Rasgen. And I'm primarily housed out of the College of Ag, as well as the Center for Infectious Disease Dynamics. What I'm really interested in is how disease-causing agents, like viruses, influence health outcomes and how different factors can affect this and change through time. Now more than ever, we understand that viruses can affect global populations, and this includes our insect populations. So as you may know, insect populations have been declining over the past couple decades, and this includes critical pollinator species, including the honeybee. What I'm interested in is how certain viruses affect global bee health outcomes, how these viruses are evolving. Furthermore, I'm looking into how the honeybee immune response to different viral strains and how that might also affect both their outcomes as well as the virus evolution. I wanted to thank the Penn State Alumni Association for this recognition and also thank Penn State. My experience here has truly transformed who I am as a scientist, and that includes Christina, who is here. Thank you to her as my advisor, and everyone else who has helped me along the way. And I'm very excited to use this momentum to finish up this dissertation and see what happens in my coming future. So thank you very much for listening.
Congratulations. And Lauren Stetz, Art Education, please come forward.
Good evening. My name is Lauren Stetz, and I'm a PhD candidate in art education with a minor in women's gender and sexuality studies. I'm very honored to be here tonight, and I would like to thank the Penn State Alumni Association for this prestigious award. I'd also like to thank my dissertation chair, who's here tonight, Dr. Karen Kiefer-Boyd, as well as my committee, including Dr. B. Stephen Carpenter II, Dr. Michelle Bay Demetriadis, and Dr. Jacqueline Reed Walsh for their support throughout my research. I'd also like to thank my mother, who's here tonight, who helped homeschool my daughter through the past year of COVID and helped me finish my dissertation, as well as my daughter, Zoya, who's here and who tolerated many years of studying and divided attention. So I'm sure she will also be happy for me to be finishing. Inspired by the monumental reach of the Me Too movement, which emphasizes the prevalence of sexual violence that many women endure in silence, my art education research draws from digital media platforms as new sources of empowerment and creative resistance for feminist activism. In my dissertation, I used a participatory action-based research framework to explore 24 artists' narratives and their artworks that address violence against women. This global study explores localized nuances of violence as revealed by culture, regional histories, and politics. Through artist interviews and mapping methodologies, I highlight the potential for artists across mediums, borders, and intersectional identities to develop coalitions within transnational spaces. My research reveals how pluralistic voices and perspectives can dislocate hierarchies of knowledge to inspire collaboration, conversation, and support. The findings of this study emphasize the power of shared trauma to construct mutually beneficial relationships between artists, activists, and scholars, offering routes towards empowerment as well as social transformation. The data visualization map created in the study provides a model for engagement in transnational conversations within the field of art education. In addition, educators can use the data visualization map, artist interviews, and artworks to construct an art education curriculum that addresses violence against women by examining global artists' works. And thank you again for this award.
Thank you all, and congratulations to each one of you on your outstanding research. I have to say, this is one of my favorite events of the year, but it always makes me feel like I really need to get moving on my career. Congratulations to all. Please join me in a final round of applause for our Alumni Association Dissertation Award recipients. In closing, tonight's alumni honorees and the Alumni Association Dissertation Award recipients, all at varying stages of their careers, serve as an inspiration to the entire Penn State community. They embody the ideals that have distinguished Penn State as one of the world's premier research universities. And finally, my last announcement is that I invite a guest seated at your table to please take home the flower centerpieces to enjoy. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Have a good night.